We're out here again on the Saginaw River, where, as you can see behind me, the tall ships have arrived and are now docking here. A lot of folks in the area coming out to look at these beautiful, beautiful ships. I mean, it's a marvelous day. We've got everybody out here in the Bay City area just having a good time and enjoying themselves. And in order to make this all possible, it takes a lot of volunteers and a lot of work. And I have one gentleman with me. His name is Gary Portier. And Gary, you are with Tall Ships and you're a parade marshal, correct?
That's correct. I'm the parade marshal. We decide what boats come in first, where they park, and how they should park. And all the boats are safely in now. They're safely parked. And the festival will begin tomorrow. So everything went according to plan, no problems, everybody was good. So I'm debarking here, and I enjoyed my trip on the Coast Guard boat.
Tell me a little bit, you know, these ships are marvelous, as I mentioned earlier, but the fact is that you guys, it takes a lot of work to make this all happen. Just give us a rundown of how you guys get them all docking here safely and make that work.
Well, first of all, it's once every 3 years. So during the other 2 years, we're in the planning stages, and then we select which ships we want to come to this harbor. And they come in. Then we have to decide which ships park in what order, depending on the depth of the water. Some ships draw more depth, so they have to have the deep spots. Some ships draw less water. We put them in the shallow spots. So that's all predetermined before the parade even starts.
Okay.
And everybody knows where they're supposed to park when they come in.
Gary, thank you so much for talking with me. Really appreciate it. And guys, once again, come on out to the Tall Ship Celebration happening all throughout the rest of this week. Once again, we are out here on the Saginaw River reporting here in Bay City. Jonathan Jackson, WNEM TV 5.